Indigenous people have always been on the front lines because our communities are just so close to the Boreal Forest and other fire-prone areas. Indigenous Guardians are going to need to start assuming some of that responsibility for managing fire. Mr. Vopidisisni, the Nisidiga Aswan. My name is Brady Highway. I'm from the Peter Ballantyne Cree Nation. Over the course of my career, I've had about 250 fires. When I was 15 years old, our cabin was being threatened by a wildfire. We had been told to evacuate, and I talked to my dad, and I was saying, you know, like, we should do everything that we can to save our camp. We spent 14 days fighting that fire. It was something that really impacted me deeply. You have these growing concerns around climate change. We could potentially have these fires that grow 180,000 square kilometers in a matter of days. It's the recipe for a disaster in many northern communities. What we want to protect, what we want to save for future generations might not exactly be what the provincial priorities are. However, Indigenous protected and conserved areas are being implemented across the country would create these opportunities for developing that capacity at the ground level so that we can manage fire in a way that holds our priorities. You know, you look at Indigenous Guardian programs, it's just one step further to provide them with the training and experience that they need to manage fire. When you're isolated in remote areas of the Boreal Forest, you're entirely dependent on the skills that you have. Indigenous Guardians, they're very capable in the bush. They grew up there. You don't need a map to tell them how to get around. I got into this industry because I felt a responsibility to look after the land, look after our traditional territories. In my mind, it's not about the heroics. It's the heart and it's the connection to the land that's the most important. Here's an incredible opportunity for Indigenous Guardians to become involved in wildland fire.